Our major corporate story today, Bell Corporation announces details of its tender offer to delist Premium Leisure from the stock exchange. Offer price was set at 85 centavos per share, determined from a fairness valuation report by First Metro Investment. The offer period begins on Friday and will last until April 24, followed by a settlement until May 9. Bellcorp Baird plans earlier this month to buy all minority-held shares of its gaming unit, worth 4.6 billion pesos. Premium Leisure holds a stake in the resort and casino City of Dreams and in Pacific Online Systems Corp. Meanwhile, Bank of the Philippine Islands raises $400 million from its dollar bond offering. The Yala Group's banking arm raised amount from its senior unsecured five-year notes for the first time since 2019. It says proceeds will be used for refinancing efforts and general corporate purposes. Still from the Ayalas, A-REIT executes a property for share swap deal with ASIN subsidiary Buendia Cristiana Holdings. Under the agreement, A-REIT will issue 200 million worth of common shares to Buendia in exchange for a 2.7 million square meter land in Zamboanga province. The property was valued at 6.7 billion pesos. And finally, Cebu Landmasters sees a 29% increase in profit last year. Net income climbed to 4.6 billion pesos, with revenues also higher by 20% to 18.8 billion. The Visayas Mindanao developer points to stronger demand for its residential units and its diverse business portfolio for the growth. This year, it's spending 14 billion pesos in capex for expansion projects, including for its inaugural project in Luzon. Warehouses of the National Food Authority are once again operational following the mass suspensions of the agency's officials. For more on this story, let's bring in our correspondent, Andrea Taguines. Hi, Andy.
Hi, Denise. The Department of Agriculture has assured local rice farmers that the National Food Authority is working on ways to still be able to buy their harvests despite the latest scandal rocking the agency. The Office of the Ombudsman earlier ordered the preventive suspension of 141 NFA officials and employees, including warehouse supervisors, prompting the closure and halting of operations of dozens of warehouses across the country at the height of the palay procurement season. This stemmed from allegations that the NFA had illegally sold 75,000 sacks of rice to private traders without going through proper auction. In a news forum this morning, DA spokesperson Arnel Demesa said NFA trucks have been deployed in areas where warehouses have been closed so that they can still go around and buy palay. He said DA Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel Jr. has also ordered NFA Officer in Charge Administrator Larry Lacson to speed up the reopening of more warehouses by replacing the suspended supervisors and thus preventing an operational paralysis. The DA's assurance comes as AgriPartalist Representative Wilbert Lee shared reports that he received from farmers who have been struggling due to warehouse closures in Nueva Ecija, which is considered the rice granary of the Philippines. He said they have been forced to sell their harvest at a lower price to local traders. But Demesa said there are still warehouses in Nueva Ecija that are operating. He added that out of the 288 warehouses in the country, 169 are currently active. Meanwhile, the lawyer of over 100 NFA employees who were preventively suspended questioned why only a few agency officials were included in the suspension order. Attorney Dino De Leon said it is unjust to sanction rank and file workers when they have no decision-making powers. While the DA is deferring to the ombudsman on this issue, it said the agency is conducting its own internal investigation.
Ang preventively suspend mo, butigero, rank and file. Pero yung mga nandun sa taas, eh, hindi kasama sa preventive suspension. We understand that this particular issue was because of an alleged report given by Assistant Administrator for Operations, Lembel Pagayunan, di ba? Pero hindi siya kasama sa preventively suspended. Kahit na Assistant Administrator na siya, nung mga nakaraang 5 million sacks disposition.
We defer yung mga ganitong decision. Sinutos din ni Secretary Chu Laurel na as far as back as 2019, i-review yung disposition na ginawa. So, you can expect na lahat ng naging transaction sa disposition ay bubusisiin at sisiya sa atin. Po ay kasali. So, kasama rin.
Yes,
yung nag-report, kasama rin.
Denise De Mesa also said that Lacton has been ordered to fully cooperate with the probe of the Office of the Ombudsman following complaints from Ombudsman Samuel Martires himself that they are being given the runaround by the NFA. For Congressman Lee, apart from top NFA officials, involved rice traders should also be held accountable. Lee also suggested that President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. take the helm at the NFA for the meantime to ensure that ongoing investigations will not be politically influenced. Denise?
Andy Taguines with that story. Thanks, Andy.